If you're a Grafana power user, then you should check out Grizzly right now. Grizzly is a CLI tool that helps you manage your Grafana resources, so dashboards and alerts, all from your codebase. And in this video, we're going to learn exactly how to use it. Now, if you're completely new to creating Grafana resources in code, then you should check out our Grafana video to help you get started. But basically, if you want to manage dashboards at scale, then the UI isn't going to cut it. It can't be version controlled, and it's not great for updating multiple visuals from different dashboards. This is where Jsonnet comes in, since it's a language that can compile to JSON. But using Jsonnet for dashboards involves copying and pasting the outputted JSON into the Grafana UI, which isn't great for managing lots of dashboards. And this is a problem that Grizzly solves in such an elegant way. So let's first go through how to install Grizzly, and then we'll go through how to add it to an existing project. This project uses Jsonnet and Grafana to create a simple Grafana dashboard with two visuals, one for CPU usage and one for memory usage. If you want to know exactly how I created this, again, check out our Jsonnet video. The link for that should be in the description. Details for each panel is inside a panels.libsonnet file, which contains the PromQL expressions used. Nothing really complicated. Okay, let's set up Grizzly. Now, the docs recommend installing Grizzly using Brew, but let's face it, Grizzly makes the most sense inside some kind of CI pipeline. So let's install it with Docker. So let's create a Docker Compose file and use the latest Grizzly image from Grafana and add a few environment variables. The first being our Grafana URL, which in my case is localhost 5000, and the second is the Grafana token. I'll tell you how to get that later in the video. Then we'll create a volume to mount our root files to the source directory in the container. We'll change the network mode to host so that our Docker container can access localhost, and then add a Grizzly command to watch for all the changes in the source directory, and if anything changes, then compile and update the main.jsonnet file. You may notice in the Grizzly documentation, all the commands start with GRR, but our command just starts with watch. This is because the Grizzly image has an entry point for the GRR command, so we don't have to use that command in our Docker Compose file. You may also notice that it installs Jsonnet along with the Jsonnet bundler, which means it's able to compile our Jsonnet code and make use of any dependencies we have. Now, if you have Grafana in the same Docker file as your Grizzly, then of course you won't need this host field, but you may also need this depends field to make sure that Grizzly only runs when Grafana is running. Now, in my case, I have Grafana running on a completely different Docker Compose file to Grizzly, so it doesn't make sense. Okay, so how do you get the Grafana token? First, go to Grafana in your browser, open the side menu and navigate to Service Account, which is inside Users and Access, which is inside Administration. Now, I already have a Grizzly Service Account, but what you'll want to do is click on the Add Service Account button, give it a name, change the role to admin, and then click create. Now from here, you'll want to click on the Add Service Account Token button. You can give it a name and then click on Generate Token. Once you've done that, copy this to your clipboard and put it inside the parameter store, an environment variables file, or somewhere else that can hold secrets. And once you've connected your source token to your Docker Compose file, you can run Docker Compose up. And if everything goes well, then Grizzly should be watching for changes. But right now, if we make any changes, Grizzly will give us an error. This is because our current project isn't in a format that Grizzly can understand. We can fix this by adding the Grizzly library to our project. But before we do that, I mean, let's face it, self-hosting Grafana to create visuals is great. But if you want a hosted option with many more features, then you should check out BetterStack. With BetterStack, you can connect metrics from Prometheus and create really nice dashboards with a drag and drop interface. But that's not all. You can also create status pages, manage incidents, create alerts, and much, much more. So go and check out BetterStack right now. And we're back adding the Grizzly library to our Jsonnet project. In our terminal, let's run the following command, which will use the Jsonnet bundler to install the Grizzly library. And once it's installed, we should see Grizzly inside our vendor directory. We can import Grizzly inside our main file, then create a variable for our dashboard, and then we'll export the dashboards field as an array, but this could be called anything you want. And here we're going to write Grizzly dashboard new, then add an ID and use our dashboard variable. You'll notice the node metrics here does not match the name we have here. In fact, this should match the UID that we add to our dashboard. And in our case, we don't have one. So let's go ahead and add one with this code. Cool, and that should be it. We'll go into Grafana and delete our existing dashboard, and we'll put the screens side by side so you can see the updates as soon as they happen. Now I'm going to save this file, And if I refresh this page, you'll see we have our new dashboard. How cool is that? We can go ahead and add a new panel. And once we save this file, it will automatically update in Grafana, even without us refreshing the page. Let's go ahead and add another panel. And if we save and scroll down, we'll see we have that new panel as well. We can even update some panel-specific stats, and all of that will update in real time. No more copying and pasting JSON files. And because Jsonnet is so flexible, you could even create a dashboard's libjsonnet file just to contain your dashboards and have your UIDs in a separate variable, which would mean having a much cleaner main file just containing the UID and the dashboard code. As well as dashboards, Grizzly can manage resources, folders, data sources, and Prometheus running on Grafana Cloud. If you want to see more of what Grizzly can do, then check out their documentation. And if you enjoyed this video and want to see more like it, then why don't you go ahead and subscribe?